Hi everyone, this is a short video about addons for Bedrock Edition of Minecraft. First of all, let's define something. Addons are pieces of content containing behavior packs or resource packs or both. You can find some on this website, the link is in the description below. Behavior packs are packs that can contain entity definitions, items definitions, blocks definitions which are currently experimental, loot tables, receipts, spawn rules, trading definitions, functions and finally scripts. It can also contain biomes definitions, but it is also experimental. Think of it as the server side of the game resources. It contains a lot of rules of how about things should go. You can think of resources like the resource pack of Java. It contains different things, but the purpose is the same, except that you can add content, and therefore it has to be done in a certain way. Knowing that, there are two sides of adding content to the game. First, you have to include it in the resource pack, then you make the definition files in the behavior pack. We will be covering both sides for integrating a complete entity to the game with models, textures, animations, and a behavior in the behavior pack. Now, let's take a concrete example. A friend of mine, Ultimatech, made this minecart called the Funk Minecart and wants me to implement it in the game. He made everything using Blockbench, a free modding software made for both Bedrock and Java version of Minecraft. The link to this software is in the description. Let's take a closer look. There are three files coming from this model: the animation files that goes in animation subfolder, the geometry files that goes in models entity subfolder, and the texture files that goes in this textures entity subfolder. The next step is to tell Minecraft to connect these three files together and say, hey, this model has this associated texture, this animation, and the animation place when this condition is triggered. Therefore, there are two more files to add to this resource pack, and we won't be done yet. The next file we'll be adding is the animation controller of the previous animation. Animation controller just says when some animations are played and what are the transitions and how it can pass from an animation to another. We won't be covering this file in depth as it is quite complex and way of range, but you can check the documentation I put in the description of the video. So before we start with the animation controller, I just wanted to remind you that every file in this tutorial is located on GitHub and there is the link in the description. So this is the basic animation controller I put in every simple animation I need to do. So the first rectangle is controller.animation.funkmaincar.move. It's the only one there and it references one animation called a move that is triggered by query.modified move speed. So you have to keep in mind that the names are very important in this file, like move and the animation controller name is really important. In fact, everything that is in the rectangles. And now there is the entity definition file of the resource pack located in entity folder, and it contains all the references to all the assets. As you can see in the rectangles, there is a lot of names in it, and you have to be very careful of the identifier, the texture spawn egg, the geometry, the textures, the animations, the animation names. I put in blue the particle files because it's a specific thing of the animation, because this animation supports particles, so I just put it there. But you have to be really careful of the names again and all. But you can use my code and change the names. It's available on GitHub again, so you can use it as you wish. Now that you have all these files in all these directories, we can start creating the behavior pack with only one file in it. It's the behavior of your entity. So this file is containing every behavior of your entity. It is quite long because I put a lot of behaviors in it, but it can be really short also. There is this website where you can find every behavior of Minecraft. There is the link in the description. And you can add everything from the horse behaviors to the pirate behaviors through the zombie behaviors. Everything is possible, so you can really customize your entity. Keep in mind that you have to put the same identifier in the resources to connect both resources and behaviors together, and then you're done. It's completely done. The pack is done. Just have to put some other files, but they are going to be on the GitHub, so just check it and download it and modify the code, it's going to be easier for you. And now that everything is done, we can mess around with this main card, the Funk main card, and we can just play with it. experiment the behaviors I just put in it, you can see that it goes way faster than the original minecart, but it's kind of funny. So if you enjoyed the video and if you found it useful, please subscribe and please just like the video or comment in the section below if you need some help or something. Bye bye.